Now, the Cook Islands National Council of Women here in New Zealand's been going for just under a year, and in Auckland recently they got together for a small celebration and to view a short film written and directed by women in the Cook Islands. John Otunga has more.
Cook Islanders like Christchurch East MP Poto Williams were among the guests at this gathering, as were key members of the business and government sectors. It's part of a plan by the Cook Islands National Council of Women to grow its presence here in Aotearoa and to create links with members back in the islands.
The issues may be the same, and those issues, how do we address them in the Cook Islands, and if they are happening here in New Zealand, how is New Zealand responding?
Also present at the gathering, islands-based producer Glenda Tuene, who's worked a lot with the group's Rarotonga-based chapter.
We've brought over three of the films that the National Council's been working on. And really the important thing about us is to be able to indicate to people that the Cook Islands can tell their own stories, that we're making contemporary documentary and contemporary film to be able to discuss the real poignant issues of our community right now.
Among the films to screen is The Island Night, which touches on some sensitive social issues. Written by a committee of women, it was the first foray into film directing by teacher Api'i Napa.
The film, The Island Night, portrays strong family values, portrays a young woman who has to grow up fast because she has to fend for her brother and herself.
I just need someone to look after my kids.
Well, you know I'll look after the both.
The message we bring out in this film is teaching our girls to be strong. Things they are faced with, like challenges, they can say it's wrong, and they can say they can choose to live their life.
As the films show, filmmaking is a thriving art form in the islands, especially among women.
A lot of people are putting their hands up to learn the techniques, learning how to become grips, learning how to become lighting techs. So as much as it may be a raw beginning, it's a beginning. And I'm really proud of the fact that we're able to bring it over here through the National Council of Women.
In the meantime, this New Zealand-based Cook Islands Women's Group want to take this inspiration further, to involve itself at a policy level.
Where we can find ourselves really making constructive contributions to the development of Cook Island women here in New Zealand.